Yes, hello dear friends, how are you? In this video, we continue with the Uhu crane inspections. Yeah, I collect some photos from previous vessels. Okay, so all of these photos not belong to same vessel. These are from different vessels. Okay, but I just want to give a general idea about these Uhu cranes. Okay. Yeah, Uhu cranes are simple and effective, but what I don't like is the side rollers, side sheaves for the electrical cables going to grabs. The electrical operated grabs, these are very big headache when the cranes becoming old. Okay, so we just easy continue. This is crane number one. İşte we just enter inside. You see here the işte sleeving, swing gear. This is the drum. This is probably laughing drum because only two fixing bolt here. Okay. This is the hoisting drum. Okay. And then you see here is some gap we have already speak before. Has to be some remain gap. Empty area for the windings. Okay, as design. So we have already checked before. Yani when you check, you can understand here some broken wires. You see small wires. In MacGregor video, I have already told about this. What is the which strategy has to be followed about the crane wire change. Okay, yani because everybody have an idea about this one. İşte several broken wires you see here. Şimdi I want to speak about this one. When your Uhu crane, okay, becoming old, this is sleeving motor, okay, here. Yani here is some electrical motor in the down turning this disc and then this motor this is the brake mechanism here, brake mechanism, and then down here electrical motor, and then it's turning the gear we have already speak in the, it is inside the crane house, okay, but this is positioned in vertical. Yani this is my crane house. Maybe I change. This is very thick. Yes. This is my crane house entrance. For example, this is my crane. İşte here is the operator cabin. So this is one of the deck. Correct. This is second deck inside. So when we enter from the cross deck, işte we climb the ladders here, and then here there is some gear. I have already show you the photos here, and then the turning gear is, yes, this is this motor. So this motor positioned in up and down condition. Motor here, the gear here, and turning the crane. So when this crane becoming old, this brake lining you see here, maybe I make zoom in, it is better. I make it double. At first this one maybe much more. Yes, this is okay. When this crane becoming old, this one, this brake, this part, this is a disc. Same, exactly same like windlass brake. Okay, yani this is making a round coming here. Okay. So this is falling down. Okay. Falling down. In here, in the down part, yani this photo angle is not showing, but when you check by eye, you will see here some small parts, okay. Some very very small cubic plates, yani it's just maybe we can say, you know, safety match. Safety match. You know, we We burn it. They have some bugs, you know. They have some bugs. Same like safety matchbox. Some small pieces they weld here. Okay. Maybe three pieces. Yeah, işte one here, işte one here, and then one maybe in the aft. Okay, but it is in the down area. Şimdi I drive here. Maybe we can show much more better. You can understand what I mean. Şimdi when you walk on deck, you will hear some mechanical voices. Metal to metal contact and it is a gırç, gırç, but it is much more sharp. Yani metal hitting to metal. Just a gırç, böyle gırç, gırç. You hear some voices, okay. These voices, if your cranes are cranes coming from here. Why? Şimdi, if we make like this. Şimdi, I am driving only here, okay. This is my electrical motor in the down. Correct. This is the shaft going up. You see here the end of the shaft. Yeah, I am just driving about, okay. This is my disk here. And outer side is disk is the brake lining. İşte piston something. This is the piston here. Here is one piston something. And here the foundation, okay. Foundation, this one. This one is, you see here. This is not this one. Not here. But this one, you see, this is the foundation. This one. This is going back. This one. This one is the foundation. They put some small pieces, okay, here. İşte one this side, one this side. So when we look from up, maybe one here, one here, and one in the back, three pieces. Okay, so when your crane becoming old, okay, this brake lining, this one, this one, this one, falling down, okay, and start to contact here with these metal parts, okay. Yani this brake lining touching this one, and when the operator sleeve the crane, swing the crane, one side these pistons open and this already contact this brake metal already contact and touching here, okay, and then when it open it's make a voice garch and when close garch again. So but it is a very strong voice you can hear from the deck. Okay, so it's mean this has to be adjusted again because it is just little fall down and start to contact in the down. Okay. So if you hear some kind of voice, you can understand your swing motor brake fall down just little. Yani, what I mean fall down just little, maybe less than half centimeter, but it start to contact the metal. Okay. In the down here, some metals they make some metal here. Okay. And then these two part touching each other and then when it is open, when close, hitting, touching here and then making voice. Okay. This is one of the typical problem of the MacGregor crane. Pardon. Crane. Okay. This is one of the problem. Yeah, this is işte hidrolik mechanism something something. I will show several photos about this one. İşte this is the wire you see here. Maybe we make double. You see here some parted wires. You see it is changed the direction. When you go to cranes, you just make a visual inspection on. You see some small small broken wire here. Here is a some gap. Too much broken here. Too much broken. So it's mean it's come easy easy come to change the wire. And easy easy. You see here. Continuously broken. Yani these wires are not very very strong anymore. Maybe, yeah, what I told you before in the MacGregor video, please watch. Yani in that condition wire, maybe you can use one time or two times in very very light cargo, okay? Yani in corn, maize, something. Yani grab plus cargo, if it is about 12 ton, 13 ton, something, okay, these wires, even if that condition you can use, it will be no problem. But it is up to you. I explain. In the MacGregor video, so you can see. This is the operator cabin. Okay. This is gone. And then we continue with the other photo. I make it fit. Yes. Ha. Maybe I make it double, it is better. Yes. Şimdi this crane have some typical design problem. Okay. What you see here. Here. This one is foundation of the electrical motor on the top. Hydraulic motor. Okay. This is the electrical part and then turning and rotating the hydraulic. Okay. Or maybe what I remember, maybe this is the cooling fan. I don't know. Yes, this is cooling fan, not electrical motor. Yeah, electrical motor of the cooling. Okay, so this is just foundation, and this is not very heavy thing. Okay, but they position the drums below here, and then when wire operating, it is touching this foundation. In the old cranes, that design problem were. When you go, you see the wire contact here and easy işte sawing the foundation. Also at the same time it's reducing the lifetime of the hoisting wire. Okay, so this is the condition of the outer. Yes, yeah, you see here these are by the time becoming very rusty and then wasted and then becoming very big headache. They in the past they put some air condition on the top, but this is also becoming waste. This is not heavy duty things, yani not suitable for the sea actually. Okay, this is the socket. You see the cutter pin is complete. This is very very important. Yeah, when you go, you just make a visual check. Okay, if any crack something, if any deformation, crane house number one. İşte we enter inside, we go. Yes, this sleeving motor. What I explain you making the voice when swing, turning this gear, okay, yani this one, turning this one, so make swing the crane. So what I mean, you see here is a different angle, so I can draw. You see they put some metals here like this, like a matchbox. Okay, so when this fall, start to contact with this one, and then when open, when close. Making voices. Okay, so this is a typical problem. Let's close this one. Okay. And then this is the işte laughing drum. This is hoisting drum. İşte hydraulic mechanism something. You see here. This is how I draw here. So şimdi this is the shaft coming here. Okay. The hydraulic part something and then my hoisting drum in there. Okay, işte this is the hydraulic part turning the drum and then this is the brake mechanism. This brake mechanism exactly the same with the windlass. Yeah, this is exactly the same thing with hydraulic and the brake, exactly the same with the windlass, mooring winches. Okay, so when you check, you see there is some deformation on this part. Yani this is maybe up part, maybe I take photo from the down part because you know it is the disc inside here, for example, işte disc like this and then outer side işte two parts. Yani we have one upper side, here is a hinge and then the down part, işte here is the open close mechanism, hydraulic something, so it is two parts. So you in the down part, it is not the exact half circle, and it becoming little like this, as you see in the photo. So you have to check, my friend, if any deformation you see like this. But why it become like this, I will explain in the later photos. But you see here, this is the bolt of fixing this. Brake lining inside. Bolt is coming like this. This is the cause of the bolt. Okay, yani in this view we cannot see because here is dark. But what is the problem inside? This bolt, this brake lining already become very thin, and this disc start to touch the bolt inside, and then it damage the bolt. You see also already. Right, this is the end. And the angel is like this. Already Damage the bolt inside, and then this bolt is not exactly upright and little shift. So little shift, easy easy, open close open close. This bolt start to have some deformation here because inside stuck up. Yeah, maybe like this. You understand what I mean? That is why it has to be checked. And when you open close, this will be not properly secure actually. This is not good, not safe. You see also pressure roller in the what pressure roller is this? I have already explained before, crane wire change. For example, this is my hoisting drum. Okay, they put some pressure roller here, also some foundation. İşte it is coming like this. There is a pressure roller here, so it is a jump preventer. Yani my wire prevents irregular winding and maybe prevents jump. This is always pushing the wire. You see, here is the pressure roller here, like this. It is something so pushing the wire. So what you see, the spring already broken. Have to be checked. This one also. Luffing and hoisting, both of them, the springs has to be checked. This is same problem. I will show another good photo about this one. You see, this is the spring. And this is pulling the pressure roller and it is pushing the wire. The spring has to be complete. Also you see it is almost drop. Yani it is at the end with the vibration almost drop. They tighten this one too much from the other side, so it damage the spring. And then this one very loosen. You see it is here. You see by the vibration, you see the color change. Here I mark. You see here is too much rusty, but here is shiny with the grace. So they just fix this one, but with the vibration it easy to open this nut, move and come to end. So we can clearly understand from the color change. You see here is rusty. White brown, here is dark brown. This is oily, gray soil. This is already. So it has to be tightened, for example, until there, for example. Okay, yani it is just has to be tightened normally. Şöyle mi yapsak? Yüz yapalım. Yes. And then, yes, this is the wires going to up. You see, here is the foundation. I will show another photo. Yeah, this is the operator cabin in the IHE cranes. You climb. How can I draw here? This is my crane house. Okay, I enter. For example, this is the here is the operator cabin. Okay, you not enter from here. There is a same like a bobby hatch. A door open like this. Yani you open. You are entering from down. Inside the operator cabin. This is always missing. Okay, this is the typical another problem. Okay, yeah, for this one nothing to do. Yani when you close it is going down with the gravity. So you can close anyway. Yani you see you enter from here, but also this has to be some rubber here because prevent the, what was the name, the voice come inside. So it is not complete. Also, you see they put something and the butterflies are missing. You see it is missing. You cannot tighten properly. All of them missing. You see here these are very big headache. In the Mitsubishi, I have already tell about they did it. Designed by only engineers because they put some additional sheave here and one more wire coming like this. So if any problem, how we change this middle wire sheave on the crane? Also same problem here. And nobody can touch this one. Only one person, maybe two person can work here, but it is very very difficult to work here. How to work, how to change this one? Yes, recording. Okay. So it is very very actually poor design. Ha, if you make like this, You have to use very very good quality. Yani stainless steel equipment. So nobody don't need to touch here because this is shipyard job actually. Yani how we will make? Okay, on board. With limited crew, with limited time. Very very big headaches. You see, it's already wasted. The pin already not upright. So maybe fall one day. Not safe also. You see, have some angle. It is all of them have angle. Not safe actually. Also these electrical motors for the wires. I don't like actually these side designs. Yani these are has to be. These are very very wasted actually. You see the railings, top railings. They somehow hit here and they damage. Also very very poor condition. When you go top, always check okay. When you make crane inspection, because sometimes when they make gracing or repair, some repair, they forgot something here, some tool. And during crane operation, maybe it fall down, hammer, something, very dangerous. So, has to be checked, my friend. Also, when you check also the railings also. Okay. The helicopter view, we all always take photo. Yes, this is also finish. And then, we come here, the next. Yeah, this is the general view of the crane. You will see same problem here, and it is worn. Here I will show photo at the end. You will see it is worn too much. Actually, this is the socket. Pardon. Yes. Yes, you see we check the cutter pin also have any crack, something, some deformation also in the pad eye, also in the socket. Okay, also we check this area, if any damaged wire, if broken wire, it indicates metal fatigue. Okay, yani we just check a general. You see, yani these are bullshit actually, all of them looking one side. Yeah, when the crane is new, it is good, but when it is old, actually not safe and not practical actually. Yani I don't like. İşte this is the general views. This is the Gypsy group. Okay, we just take photo. İşte this is the lights already wasted. Yani light of the cranes. We enter işte this everything. Also same. You see, same. It is already drop. This is the, what was the name? The pressure roller. You see the hoisting drum coming like this. Pressure roller is here is the pressure roller pushing the wire, but all the spring, everything drop with the vibration. They has to be regularly check. Okay, you see spring on the floor. In that crane, there was a big oil leakage actually, so I take photo, you see, not good condition actually. This vessel was old, not good. We have too much problem with the cranes in that vessel. Here. Yes, we continue. İşte this is another general, same here, just little touch. Here, general photos, we enter inside. Crane house, Allah, not good, also not good. Also this, here yani, bak, I will show later yani, if paint. Because this is not from the paint, but from the oil. Here indicates too much hydraulic oil coming from up. Okay, because it damaged the paint. Pardon. We proceed forward. Yes. We just check işte. Okay, and these cranes are not in good condition actually. Also missing. It is already jump. Wire already jump. It is wasted, totally wasted. This electrical cable and the what was the name? The pilot wire they say this one pilot. Stabilizer wire of the grab. Yani one side stabilizer wire go, one side electrical cable go. Or you see this is the hinge broken already. You see here this is electrical cable, the other side grab stabilizer wire, pilot wire. İşte. You see the socket here and we just check if any damage something. We just check the railings. Yeah, these railings are already. When you go up, always be careful, my friend. Always, okay. Don't worry. This is already wasted. Also, this when you enter the cabin, the handle is missing. Lock is missing. This is for the securing the Jeep. What I told you, you know, when you put in parking position, they just secure. I never use this one. This is already wasted. The wire sling. But anyway, I never use. Never. Yeah, this is the light foundation already damaged. Okay. Because why this is important? Because this the lamp here maybe can fall. Okay. Yani because this wire is very foundation is already damaged during operation. İşte we check the socket. This is the jump preventer. Okay. And then we proceed with the next one. Crane number 4. Yes, I show you here. You see, laughing wire going up and then touching the foundation. This is in the past already touching too much. In the past, in the old cranes. Okay. But you see also touching the cable here, electrical cable. A design problem actually. Yani very big design problem because it is reducing the lifetime also here. Yani touching cables, foundation, what is this? What bullshit? You know, yani it is a very good touching. And also eating the wire. Also you see too much here. So even if... You see the foundation coming already eaten too much. Maybe most probably it is proceeding like this. And it is this wire is worn. It is reducing the lifetime of the my friend. If your cargo wire, hoisting wire broken, okay. Most probably what I told you, it will be broken 99% when first time lifting the grab inside the cargo hold. So there will be nobody. 99% like this. Maybe another thing some can happen. But this is a gambling. You don't know when the laughing wire will be broken. So if it is fall anytime, all the crane will fall. This is very very dangerous, my friend. Very dangerous, you know. So actually has to be considered. Yani you see here actually bullshit. So when you little heave up the jeep, so it's easy roll and keeping away from here. But actually this is not a good design. Yani this is not a good design. Also you see here the hydraulic mechanism of the wire. So you just adjust from here, but I want to show something. Also, you see, it is broken before, my friend. Don't forget this cranes when you check. You have to check here. This connection of the hinges, okay, of the hydraulic. Also up, yani this connection with the, what was the name, the brake metal. And this hinges, this connection area, you must check why. When it becoming old or if it is not properly adjusted, if you tighten too much, this hydraulic mechanism turning open close here and it is broken, these connections, okay, making crack and then broken. So, it happened to me one time in one operation. You see, they have already weld something, they make some operation here. before already. You see some adjustment not. Exactly, this is exact same. Almost same with the wind last morning. You see, they already make some welding something. Don't forget here, these are must be properly calibrated. Okay, it is also the hinge part. This is the other side. This is the hinge part. Has to be these parts check if any crack something. Also this adjustment has to be made properly, my friend. This is very very important. Yani this is not only deck department. This adjustment together according to the booklet together with the engine. Yani especially chief engineer together has to be made. You see it is already maybe this damage the what was the name? The bolt here. Yani this is already they work here before. Yani they make some welding because here probably a crack. Most probably. You see. This is very important, my friend. Yani in the IHA crane, you must check when you go first. Check. You may tell, maybe you can tell, hey my friend, what are you talking about? Yani how it can be happen, but believe me, it can be happen. I will show you some photo in at then. Also same problem, you see here. Some deformation. You see, it is also not the center line. Yani, I will draw a line here. You see, from the center. It is not upright. You see, it is just have some angle. Have some angle here, yani some little angle. It is already deformed before here. Already deformed. And you can understand some problem happened before. A serious problem happened. Maybe very, very, very near miss, huh? Maybe. So when you fix also you see they put some hook here. So the free end of the wire after this fixing mechanism on the drum. So you just roll here and connect. This is good application actually. I like this one. So at the end, after crane wire change, I make a wire so we can understand if any shift something, some problem, we can understand. Okay. So this is also important. Has to be checked. Okay. And then this is the photos. It is touching. You see, it is bullshit. This is laughing drum. Also, exactly come to end. Yani this is no good. Also, because you see, they not make proper adjustment of the limit. You see, it is almost double layer. Yani it is little bit high, and then the last wire touching here. They didn't make the adjustment of the limits. Yani it is completely touching. No good. You see here. That is why I told you always leave empty winding. This is the end of the drum. You see, yani wires coming like this, and then start to increase, and the last wire like this, and then it is almost touched the end, and then touching here, it's not intact, making an angle here. Yani. It's coming like this, and then coming like this. No good, my friend. So that is why the limit adjustment must be made properly. You see, they already what I told you last two winding remain empty. Yeah, this here is not winding. It is not like this. You know, there is no set inside. This is just fabrication design. But the last two windings must be empty, my friend. Don't forget. Okay. You just check işte, you can arrange işte, we several photos, pardon. I proceed too fast actually, I may be, yes, pardon. I just make like this, yes. Yeah, this is typical. Okay, when you work with the IHA cranes, almost same işte, we just check the cutter pin. Any crack, any metal fatigue, any deformation. So we just check. You see, too much oil. Extreme oil leakage. And then Also electrician change some lamp but put inside. Yani nobody check. Yes, this is the same. Yeah, you see here. Don't forget last two leave blank. Also check if they are tight. Tighten, no missing, nothing. Okay. This is same. Yeah, they you understand what I mean. They put some metal part down so when it fall down it touching. İşte this is the electrical, the oil leakage, too much oil leakage in here. You see this is the pressure roller. I saw you the some spring in the down. Fall down, broken spring something. These are the pressure rollers. Yeah, this is for the what was? This is hoisting I think, yeah. Maybe. Maybe. Yeah. No, this is laughing. Yes. But also same for the hoisting in the down. Has to be checked. Yeah, these are same işte. Same problems. But you see, I think here some problems. Huh? Because this is why maybe I take photo. Maybe the photo angle, I don't know, but maybe some problem with that socket. Huh? Maybe dur. I just make like because if we start from the center and we proceed by the center, pardon. Why like this? Ya? If I put from the center, yes. You see, there is some angle here also. I think maybe some deformation to do some bend, some small bending you see here, yani maybe some deformation like this. I don't know, maybe because of the photo, I don't know, but it is not exactly upright. You have to check too much thing, my friend, don't forget. Okay, also the metal fatigue here. So we check the railings, something. We check electric motors, işte gypsy group. What I told you before, you know, if any paint crack starts, it indicates some problem. So here several paint crack, but 99% these are not painted before because of the paint condition. Okay, yani. But anyway, 99.99% because of the, what was the name? The paint. Flakes, this is rust flake, poor painting. But anyway, if you see something like this, maybe you can make a job request from engine to make a deflection test, something. Also işte the air conditioning, something. You see, this is also operator cabin, side bolts, also too much rusty, maybe. You see, because there is some paint crack starts. Yani. On the sides. What I show. Yes, okay. Also here, do we have anything? Yeah, these are almost same, I think. There is no extra. Here, same. You see, this hydraulic mechanism. Always check the connections. Here, other side, the hinge. Always check. Okay, if any crack. The inside, very poor condition, yes. I think we have already seen this one. Huh, I will show something. Anyway, we start from here. You see here, işte this is maybe the oil leakage, because of the oil leakage. This is hydraulic oil filter inside, in the crane. İşte this is the drums, something. You see broken wires in the crane. This is too much broken. You see some parted wire here. You see here, some localized. Actually, this wire is not in good condition, but you see what I mean in the, what was the name? In McGregor Mitsubishi Crane. They already put only one gear here. One gear from laughing. This is going to limit box gear here. Also this one down gear in the hoisting drum coming to here. But you see, you can adjust the tightness with this one. In the what was the name? Mitsubishi Crane. There is no third gear. And then you cannot adjust the tightness, okay? And when you are fixing it, also much more difficult. So you see, one bolt here, one nut here, one nut here. So when you loosen, you can shift this one. You see here, you can shift up and down, so you can adjust the tightness of the chain. So this is actually much more good design. So when you crane wire change, okay, what I told you before, for the crane wire change, pardon. Here, what will you do? You just loosen this one, just slack, and then you take this wire completely out, okay? Take out, put somewhere here, okay? And then you change the wire, and then when in the final, come to same position, you just fix the wire here, and then you adjust with this one up and down, and then finish the story. Okay, but this limit box has to be removed, must be removed from the hoisting or laughing. When you change the wire, you see this is the işte laughing. This is the hoisting also. This is for the grab operation. Auto mode, manual mode, something, something too much. Okay, bullshit. I don't like, my friend. You just take photo from işte. This is the jump preventer, something. Wires, stabilizer wire, pilot wire. Yes, we finished this video. Okay. And then in the next video, we will continue with the other second video of the crane. Okay. Thank you very much for watching.